magnificent tank, spectacular geometry, ancient wisdom, spiritual legacy of 1,000 years and sunlit path. Today, my way is towards Modhera Sun Temple. Modhera is located in Mehsana district of North Gujarat, 100 kilometers away from Ahmedabad. Well-laid road took me to Modhera in less than 2 hours. Welcome back to my channel. I am Girija Raikwa. I make videos on ancient temples and heritage sites. Today we are in one special temple in Gujarat. I think you can guess this. This is the temple of the god of light and life, Sun. Surya's temple. Sun temple of Modhera. I am here just at the entrance of the Sun temple. I came this morning from Bengaluru to Ahmedabad. I am looking very tired. Now I will take ticket. Let's see how much is the ticket per adult. And then we will get inside the temple. This site is maintained by Archaeological Survey of India and the ticket for Indians it is 25 rupees and for foreigners 300 rupees. You can also pay by scanning the code where you get the discount of 5 rupees per ticket. Here it is written something about Sun Temple. So excited to be here and let's see what is there, what kind of sculptures are there. Let's go and explore. Built in 1025 by Bhimdev of Solanki dynasty, Modhera temple is 1000 years old. Some scholars opine that it might have been built even before 11th century. Only proof to say that it was built in 1025 is a small inscription available inside. Some scholars say that that inscription is marking the date of destruction by Ghazni when he plundered Somnath temple. Solankis are Chalukyas of Gujarat. Due to Apabhramsha, it became Solanki. Chalukya, Chaulukya, and then it became Solankis. There is a small museum where rare sculptures are kept that can also be visited. So I have with me today the travel guide of this place, Vipulji. Hello Vipulji.
Namaste.
September 5th, PM is going to come here. This is going to be the first solar village in India. So what are you doing? You have solar panels for each house?
Every house is ke chhat ke upar solar panel dalenge.
What a tribute to Sun Temple when each and every house is going to get solar power to each and every house and they need not have to pay. Wow. Thanks to the government. Last year this was in news when PM Modi tweeted this when it was raining during monsoon. Surya worship was so common in those days. We can see Surya Suktas, Savitra Suktas in Rigveda as well. In Rigveda there are many Suktas and in Upanishad, especially in Chandogya Upanishad, I remember I have seen some verses related to sun. Sun temples were very common those days, but today they are very few of them who have survived. One is in Konark, which kind of very famous, everyone are aware of it. And the second one is here in Gujarat, Modhera. There are some more temples in Gujarat and also I can remember Marthanda temple in Kashmir and Suryavara temple in Tamil Nadu. I understand there are few more sun temples in Madhya Pradesh as well. If you see in Karnataka where I am coming from, in each and every ruin, we can find one or the other shrine of Surya. And we can see many sculptures even in Hoysalas, umpteen number of Surya structures we can, Surya sculptures we can see. So that shows how much Surya was a kind of worshipped as a main deity those days. But today we find very few of them. And thankfully, this temple has survived in spite of Alauddin Khilji's destruction. He destroyed it.
In 1027, Muhammad Ghazni destroyed the temple when he invaded Somnathpur. Then in 1299, Alauddin Khilji again destroyed the temple, and afterwards it survived an earthquake as well.
Let's go and see the first one. What we see here is Suryakund, and beyond that, what you see there is Sabha Mantapa. Behind that is Garbhagriha. It's very interesting. They are kind of both fire and water are brought together here. This is Suryakund, or people call it as Ramkund as well.
Why this is called as Ramkund?
So in Puran, ये बताया गया है कि रावण को मारने के बाद गुरु वशिष्ठ के आज्ञा से भगवान रामचंद्र यहाँ पर ब्रह्म हत्या दोष से मुक्ति पाने के लिए, उसके दोष निवारण के लिए आए थे। उस टाइम यहाँ के मूढ़ ब्राह्मीण लोगों ने उनको जो विधि विधान करवाया था उनसे प्रसन्न होकर उन्होंने ये गांव उनको ताम्र पत्र के ऊपर लिख के दान दक्षिणा में दिया था। तो इसीलिए लोकल पीपल इसको सूर्यकुंड और रामकुंड दोनों के नाम से पहचानते हैं।
एज पर पुराणास मोधेरा वास कॉल्ड एज धर्मारण्य, सिमिलर टू नैमिषारण्य। इट इज बिलीव्ड दैट रामा केम हियर टू प्यूरिफाई हिमसेल्फ आफ्टर किलिंग रावणा, विच वाज अ ब्रह्महत्या दोष, एंड देन दिस इज कॉल्ड एज रामकुंड। नाउ लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द आर्किटेक्चर। दिस टेम्पल इज बिल्ट इन मारो गुर्जरा स्टाइल आर्किटेक्चर एज पर धाकी, and you can see three parts in the temple. First is Suryakund, next Sabha Mantapa, and Guda Mantapa, where Mula Sthana is there, Garbhagriha is there. This is the view from the southern side, where there is an important shrine. Suryakund houses 108 shrines, which is a significant number in Indian culture.
Adideva namastubhyam prasida mama bhaskara.
Though it looks like stepwell, this is not stepwell. Stepwell is for all purpose. It is a utilitarian purpose. But this is Suryakund. It is just like in southern areas, what we call it as Kalyani or Pushkarani. It is called as Kund here in North India.
Suryakund is 176 feet long from north to south and 120 feet from east to west. Out of all the 108 shrines, Sheetala Devi Shrine is the largest one towards the south side. Doorways are delicately carved like any other temple. Here we can see Ganesha, Varaha, and many other images. Sheetala Devi is the form of goddess who is known for curing chickenpox. In South India also, in Karnataka, we use Sitala Sidbo, that is the word that we use for chicken pox, and there also there is a goddess that whom we worship. Sheetala Devi is having 12 hands. She is holding something on top of her head. She is sitting on a donkey. It is almost broken, damaged image. And in other arms, she is holding multiple weapons. In one of her hands, she is holding broomstick. And people say that she, in one hand, her attribute is to hold a neem ka patta.
Prayer bhi karte the aur Ayurveda.
Aaj bhi worship karte hain kya?
Aaj bhi karte hain. Every year. And Gujarati month, yani Hindi month, hame Hindu jo Vikram Samvat. Into every month, Saptami tithi jo hoti hai, Sheetala Devi ki mani jati hai. To kai jagah Saptami tithi ke din log garam bana ke nahi khate, agle din ka banaya hua thanda hi khana khate hain. क्योंकि शीतला देवी के शीतला सप्तमी होती है, सावन मास में आएगी कृष्ण पक्ष में। तो सप्तमी के दिन जो महिलाएं होती हैं चूल्हा नहीं जलाती, वो उसी दिन अगले दिन का बनाया हुआ ठंडा खाना ही खाती हैं और देवी का आशीर्वाद पाती हैं।
इट इज बिलीव्ड दैट शी विल कैरी डोंकीज मिल्क, दैट इज हर व्हीकल। डोंकीज मिल्क, वी कैन रिमेंबर क्लियोपात्रा, शी वॉज यूजिंग, लेजेंड से दैट शी वॉज यूजिंग डोंकीज मिल्क to have glowing skin.
The shrine of Sheetala Devi itself is like a full-fledged temple. It has nakara, shikhara, and it has carvings. You can identify all the parts of the temple in this small shrine. This is the only shrine which is intact. Rest of them are partially damaged.
Wow! Behind Sheetala Devi, there is a beautiful carving of Harihara. We can see here, he is having Chakra, Shankha, and here Trishul, Shiv, and there is Nandi.
The concave body of the tower has fine network of carvings. On top of the tower, we can see Amalakka in place, but Kalasha is missing.
Saptashwarathamarudham prachandam kashyapatmajam shvetapadmadharam devam tam suryam pranamamyaham.
From iconography perspective, Suryakund houses many unique sculptures. I have not seen similar ones in other places. Ganesha is sitting with his consort. In South India, we assume Ganesha as a bachelor, but here he is a married man. How beautiful this Trivikrama sculpture is. It is very different from South Indian architectural style. Here, Bali's head is there on top. Generally, we see his head bottom, but here it is on top. He is having 8 arms. And from the other figures down, we can see the narrative. This one is my favorite. Here, Surya is represented along with other Ashtagrahas, totally Navagrahas, along with himself, sitting on a chariot driven by 7 horses. This image is partially broken, but still we can see the beauty. And from left, second one is Agni with his bear can be seen.
Devam tam suryam pranamamyaham traigunyam cha mahashuram brahma vishnu maheshwaram mahapapaharam devam tam suryam pranamamyaham.
Another interesting image is Nar Narayan. Right side you can see a human being and left side who is like a king or he might be a god. And this is identified as Nar Narayan, who will again born in Dwapara Yuga as Krishna and Arjuna. Cannot identify the attributes of Narayana because of weathering effects. His hand is broken and I can't make out what he is holding.
Though it is Suryakund, there are many other deities. Vishnu is there, Shiva is there, Kartikeya is there, Ganesha is there, Brahma is there.
108 shrines can be recognized.
But though they are made out of sandstone, they have been kind of eroded. Today we can't see very clearly what it is. But there are 108. You can imagine the grandeur.
And how prosperous the ruler who built this. This shrine is located on the northern side of the tank. This is meant for Shiva. This one is the cute one where Parvati is sitting, putting her right hand on Shiva's shoulder, just like friends.
Nataraja. Looks like these are all rishis.
Yeah.
Their hairstyles are different, just like Vijayanagara style in Lepakshi. What we see, the huge murtis of these rishis whose headgear is different from each other. Here also we can see so many headgears. And
aapke South India mein kalke Ganesh ji ko behtar mante
hain?
South India mein Ganesh ji ko behtar
mante hain.
Hamare yahan Kartikeya ko behtar mante
hain. This is the world of temples. Once we are at the bottom of the tank, we can feel that all around us, multiple temples, 108 shrines and different deities. It's an experience. Look at the composition and geometry of the tank. Small pyramidal stairways arranged in staggered rows lead from one terrace to the other. There are 4 different terraces in this
Suryakund. Prabhuncha sarva lokanam tam suryam pranamamyaham.
This shrine is in the center of eastern side of the tank. Here we can see Sheshashayi Vishnu. In the below panel, there is a Samudramanthana narration. Bhairavi, her face is completely damaged. And then there is Brahma and Brahmani. In this shrine, the sculptures are totally eroded, maybe due to weathering effect or because of water level when it was high. Maybe stone was not good. It is very difficult to make out what it is.
I could spot a turtle.
Turtles are considered as very auspicious ones in any Hindu temples. Even in Vietnam, I have seen that turtles are considered as very auspicious and they are kind of a reincarnation of Vishnu. Of course, Vishnu's Kuruma Avatara is there. Faruqi, court poet accompanied along with Ghajni, has written this. Like Mondar, a place where there was a tank, such one, at which the two eyes of thought were indeed dazzled. Such a tank that however I might contemplate, I cannot adequately express its qualities. It bore signs of excellence of the people. It gave indication of abundant riches. It was a wide and expansive tank with 100,000 acts. Around it are 1,000 small temples. It was eye-strikingly beautiful then, 1,000 years ago, and even today. If the Kund itself is so beautiful, you can imagine the richness in the main temple. That is for next video. Om Namo Suryaya Namaha.
Adideva Namastubhyam Prasida Mama Bhaskara. Divakara Namastubhyam Prabhakara Namostute. Saptashwarathamarudham Prachandam Kashyapatmajam. श्वेतपद्मधरं देवं तं सूर्यं प्रणमाम्यहम् लोहितं रथमारूढं सर्वलोकपितामहम् महापापहरं देवं तं सूर्यं प्रणमाम्यहम् त्रैगुण्यं च महाशूरं ब्रह्मविष्णुमहेश्वरं महापापहरं देवं तं सूर्यं प्रणमाम्यहम् ब्रह्मितं तेजसां पुञ्जं वायुमाकाशमेव च प्रभुं च सर्वलोकानां तं सूर्यं प्रणमाम्यहम् बन्धूकपुष्पसङ्काशं हारकुण्डलभूषितम् एकचक्रधरं देवं तं सूर्यं प्रणमाम्यहम् तं सूर्यं जगत्कर्तारं महातेजः प्रदीपनम् महापापहरं देवं तं सूर्यं प्रणमाम्यहम् तं सूर्यं जगतान्नाथं ज्ञानविज्ञानमोक्षदम् महापापहरं देवं तं सूर्यं प्रणमाम्यहम्।